Start by taking your piece of inside round and getting to know it. Orient it the way that you feel comfortable and start slicing it into half-inch slices. Once you have all your slices, make sure that you stay consistent. Consistency is key here. If the slices are all the same size, your dice will all be the same size. One trick here is to take your first piece that you want to create as a master, put that off to the side, and then match each piece of dice as closely to that masterpiece as possible. And that's very critical to the end outcome of everything being the same tenderness. Bits of gristle like this, or any other bits, trim them off, put them in the garbage. Let's add some canola oil, season with salt and pepper, and stir to mix. Cover with cling film and set to the side, or if you're doing this the day before, put it in the fridge and it can sit there for at least 12 hours. Part of what makes braising such a great technique, not only the tenderness that it creates, but the amount of flavor that it creates. And aromatics are at the very center of that. We've got onions, mushrooms, and garlic. Very traditional European flavor profiles. Let's start with the onions. We're gonna do them into a fine julienne. Speed is not important here. Accuracy is more important. Take your time and be safe. For our mushrooms, we're going to either cut them in quarters or sixes, depending on their size. Just like the beef dice, try to make sure everything is about the same size. For the garlic, we're gonna wanna have nice thin slices. There's no need to dice or mince or chop, but if you're going to use chopped garlic, you might wanna consider adding a little more. Once everything's done, clean as we go, and we're off to the next step. In order to start searing the beef, let's get a large 10-inch pan on heat and get it hot. Next, we're going to add our bacon fat. I always use bacon fat. It's just flavor, but amplified. Keep working in small batches, allowing the pan to not be overwhelmed. We want to sear and not boil. Once your beef is seared, remove to a baking sheet with a wire rack. And if you have the luxury of having a gas stove, you can get a little bit of flame happening if you're comfortable with that, and that does provide extra flavor. Once we have all our meat seared, we don't want to lose those flavorful juices. Add your mushrooms, add some seasoning to the mushrooms, and those mushrooms will absorb all of the fat and the flavor from the fond, those brown bits, and that goes right into your braise. Let's go to the next step. To start our braise, we're going to want to grab a 5-quart Dutch oven and add our onions. We want to season the onions with a bit of salt and pepper. This is the only time and opportunity we have to allow these to soften properly. Once your onions are nice and soft, we're gonna add our garlic. Same thing, we need to soften that now or it won't happen later. We can add our mushrooms and stir to combine. We can start with our first flavorful braising liquid. We're gonna add the red wine to the hot pot and allow to reduce. We're going to let it reduce almost down to a syrup, which in the technical French kitchen is known as au sec, meaning too dry. We are concentrating these flavors down to a highly flavorful syrup. Once your red wine's au sec, we're gonna add our, everyone's favorite word, Worcestershire sauce. It makes everything just taste so much better. So again, we're gonna bring that to au sec. Once your Worcestershire sauce is au sec, we're gonna add our beef broth. Now you can use house-made beef broth. I would if we were at the restaurant.
Danger.
Or you can use a Tetra Pak of beef broth. Again, an excellent choice. My suggestion is a low sodium one. Or recently I found this product, Better Than Bouillon. It is amazing, so flavorful. And this is not a paid promotion. They have never contacted me. This stuff, get it on Amazon, delivered right to your door. The link's right in the description. Once we have our beef broth in, we're going to lid. We can take a big deep breath. Catch you on the next step. All right, so now we have to process the start of our garnishes. We're gonna take our dill, bunch it together, slice it very finely, and that's it. Remove to a bowl and move on to the pickles. The pickles, we're going to take vertical slices as close as possible, and then take those vertical slices flat. Cut julienne strips. Take all of your julienne strips, turn them 90 degrees counterclockwise, and cut into dice. Just like the onions, safety first. Next up, buttered bacon noodles. It's the hallmark. On the right-hand side, we've got a review of how I make my pastas. And on the left-hand side, we've got our buttered bacon noodle preparation. Add butter to a pan, add bacon dice, add your cooked noodles, reheat, season with pepper, and you're ready to go. It is that simple. Catch ya when we're finishing the braise. With the braise out of the oven, or out of the crock pot back on the stove, bring it to a simmer, and then add our cornstarch slurry. We're gonna wanna add enough slurry to make this very thick, because then we're gonna be adding sour cream to thin it back out again. Once we've added our sour cream, we're gonna see that the braise will thin out a little bit, and that's perfectly okay. That's where it needs to be. We're gonna add our chopped fresh dill, about half, and then we're gonna add about a half of our pickles. We wanna save some pickles back for the final presentation. And that's it, it's really that simple. We've added our sour cream, our dill, and our pickles, and we've made stroganoff. It's now time to go to the plate. Now that we're ready to plate, take two big tongfuls of our buttered bacon egg noodles, and make a small ring in the middle. Plate your stroganoff into the middle of the ring. Once your portion's finished, top with sour cream, scatter some fresh dill pickles, and then finish off with a scattering of fresh dill. And there we go. It is glorious, rich, unctuous, that nice dill freshness, and it eats great every time. Doesn't matter if it's a crisp spring night, the middle of a driving snow blizzard in the winter, or I gotta tell you, even in the summer, it's still fantastic. If you found value in this video, please give this video a like. Engage us with some comments down below. I'll answer any questions that I possibly can. The recipe is available right here in this short video. Thanks, folks. Have an amazing day. And always remember, I'm your chef, not your cardiologist. Take care and happy eating.